Now, one of the coolest parts about R is that you can download packages, groups of functions that other people have written to help you do specific things, like create cool graphs or process qualitative data, or you can even write your own package. We're going to learn how to install these packages. So one of the easiest ways to install a package if you're in R Studio is to click on the Packages tab in the lower right pane. This gives you a list of all of the packages that are already installed. Your initial download of R will have installed an awful lot of packages. But let's add a new one. Click the Install button, and we're just going to type GG Extra with a capital E. It should auto-complete. Make sure you have Install Dependencies clicked, and just click Install. This will give you the command line command, the function install.packages, that you could have typed yourself, and then installs this particular package. Now once we have a package, you can see that it's down here in our system library. If we scroll down to GG, oops, there we are, GG Extra, adding marginal histograms to ggplot2. But we can't use any functions from it until we load it as a library. So I'm going to open up the source pane, and we're going to start a new script where the first thing we do is load this GG Extra library. Right. Once we run that, now we can use functions from the GG Extra library. But if you run the function called run example, capital E, and you'll see here in the tooltip that inside of these curly brackets, it says GG Extra. It means that this function, run extra, comes from the package GG Extra. So this function takes no arguments, so you just open and close parentheses and then run it. And what it will do is open up a web browser window and give you a Shiny app that you can play with, so you can see what GG Extra can do. And we can do, say, change the density plots to histograms. We can look at just the x-axis one, or add it back to both. You can play with this yourself. But one other thing that we're going to want to do for this class is to download the class package. Our class itself has a package that provides a few interesting functions for you and gives you access to the class book offline. This is a development package. It's not on CRAN yet. You might hear about CRAN a lot, and that's the repository for R packages, sort of official R packages that have been vetted by the CRAN organization. Anybody can write a package, but if they're hosting it themselves, say on GitHub, you need to download it, install it in a different way. So we're going to use a package called DevTools. If you don't have DevTools, if this doesn't autocomplete for you, what you'll want to do is install packages DevTools and run that first to install DevTools. And this might take a little while, so we're not going to reinstall it here. But we're going to use a function in DevTools called install GitHub. And we're going to install the scteachr msc-data-skills. So we're going to install a package from the course website. And we're going to run that. And what this will do is download the functions that I'll be showing you how to use. Now, another way that we can use packages without installing the or adding them with the library function is just start the your command with the name of the package. So the name of this package is dataskills. As you start typing it, you should see it autocomplete. And now we're going to, well, first we can look at this list of functions that are available in dataskills. So we have app. You can launch a Shiny app, and I'll show you how to do that later. Book gives you access to the book. And then these are data sets. So country codes, discussed, data sets that we'll be using in the book. Exercise is another function that sets up the different exercises for you. So we're going to look at the book function first. Just type data skills book and run that. And this should pull up a local version here. So you can see that it starts with file and it's wherever the your R package is keeping package files. Where you can look at data skills for reproducible science, even if you're not connected to the internet. Okay. The other thing we can do is pull up the Shiny app. So there's several different Shiny apps in the data skills package. We have to call them by name. So we'll look at one called Plot Demo. And this lets you see how several different plots look with different types of data. So we can change how many participants are in the data set, how big the main effect of task is, main effect of group, or the interaction. You can see which kind of plot might be best to plot certain types of interactions or main effects. And the other thing we can, other function we can use here is exercise. So you can say which chapter you want an exercise from. So let's open up the exercise for chapter one. And you can say whether or not you want answers. So file name, you can specify what name you want to save the file as. And if you set answers to true, it'll give you a file that has the answers. Now, don't look at the answers on the first go with the formative exercises, but after you've had a try and maybe get stuck, you can have a look at the answers. So if you run this function, it'll open up an RMD file, which we're going to talk about next, that contains all of the exercises for that chapter. And you can fill in these code chunks with your own code. So that's how we can install packages, either with the Packages tab, installing packages with the Install Packages function, or if they're not packages on CRAN, but are instead available on GitHub, you can use DevTools Install GitHub.